S M R. Hey, how are you? How are you doing? How are you keeping? Are you keeping as okay as can be? How's your weekend going? Please let me know below in the comments. My weekend's been okay. Really, I can't really complain. It's been a busy one, it's been a sunny one, it's been a hot one. I went to this beautiful park today that I've never been to, and there were swans on the lake, and it was just incredible, really, really inspiring. Yeah, just wanted to do something creative after I'd been there. Isn't it funny how sometimes, you know, the physical world, just changing your circumstance a little bit, getting into a different place can inspire you so much, you know? I used to do that a lot when I was living away. My housing setup at that particular time was a bit sketchy, and it was in quite a noisy environment, and so just like neighbours at that time, it was like 5 or 6 years ago, what I would do is I would just get out and go to the beach or something and just change up the circumstance I was in, because it was better than being in the noise and ruminating on it, you know? I don't know if you're in a similar sort of circumstance. But yeah, that's a really powerful thing. If you're in a difficult headspace, just kind of subtly changing your environment for a little bit helps a lot, I find. Though saying that, I think I'd probably live in a VW van if I could. Just like the idea of just, I don't know, starting the engine and moving on to somewhere else if you don't like the particular area. Although I'm not quite sure how I would receive my mail. Maybe get a P.O. box or something like that. I don't know. Has anyone lived in a van before? I kind of did when I was touring a little bit. I still had a home I could go to in worst case scenarios, but with touring so incessantly, you spend a large majority of your time in a van, and that van almost becomes your second home, and you're incredibly lucky if you have a place to stretch out and relax for a little bit, or to sleep in. Our tour buddies, they had a great, like, LDV set up, all bunks and stuff, all memory foam. It was incredible. But we had, like, the LDV pilot or something, which was tiny, with these horrible chairs that just made you sit upright. There was no slouching at all. And sort of 7 hours of driving in this rattly, cold LDV van would take its toll on your back quite a bit. Gosh. But yeah, changing your physical circumstances will help you a little bit. It might have somewhat of a positive effect on your mental health, especially if you're in a place that's ruminating, that you're ruminating a lot. As I said, you know, it was just so annoying being around all the noise all the time, so I would go out and do things. Like, I would go to, like, the library until it closed, and use the internet there, and get on with booking more shows. At that particular time in my life, so I wouldn't have to be stuck in that house that I was in, surrounded by noise, because by the time that I'd come back, everyone had settled down for the night, so I was still able to be productive and avoid a lot of the noise. tend to fall asleep best to chaos or chaotic soundscapes or bassy soundscapes. What about you? Do you fall asleep to a particular style of video, soundtrack, podcast? When I was about 13, I used to fall asleep to Guns N' Roses. Use Your Illusion. I had this idea where I could just fall asleep and learn a language, so I tried out for a bit. It didn't really work. And I tried all the lucid dreaming videos and all of the learn things as you sleep videos, but yeah, nothing stuck, that's for sure. There's too much damage to my frontal lobes. Frontal lobes. It reminds me, I want to do a video for people who are involved in dementia or who might be living with dementia coming up. Specifically for caregivers, I think, soon. I've had a couple of requests about one, my experiences and what tips I can offer to help those that might be going through it, because it's so prevalent these days. Some tips and tricks that might be able to help you get through through those difficult times until you have professional support, if that of course is available, depending where you are in the world, obviously. But yeah, I hope that you're doing okay, really. Still haven't got around to that 30 triggers video yet. Do it soon. It's just like when you plan for some free time, there's like 100 more things that sort of pop up, but you know what I mean? So it's just trying to make it all work. But I'm really enjoying uploading and just rambling at you in the hopes that somehow this might help you relax or offer you some distraction in some way, shape or form. And I'm looking forward to capturing some more footage with the GoPro and incorporating that into the videos as well as we go, and just continue to build a community of love. And I don't want to be cheesy, understanding, I guess. Yeah, just understanding, I think that's the one. Let me know where you are in the world before you obviously hit the subscribe, like, and notification bell. I just